We're here to talk about the DuraVision IP decoding monitor by EIZO. And thanks for joining me. I appreciate it.
Hey, thanks for having me, Matt.
So before we talk about DuraVision's new announcement about their integration to Genetec, explain for us what the DuraVision IP monitor actually is.
Yep. So the DuraVision IP monitor, what it is a 16-channel decoder built inside of a flat panel monitor. So EIZO's always been known for really high quality displays. What we took is our know-how from a number of other markets where we can take in the video, decode it, and display it with amazing quality, and then make that video easily available to market to places where users had a hard time placing IP video in the past.
What do you mean by that? Like, where would be a hard time placing it?
Well, when people moved from analog to digital for their cameras, they found it a little difficult. They had to start installing a VMS workstation, or they had to start using KVM extenders. You know, this was a lot of extra parts, a lot of extra components that, you know, they weren't used to deploying, and it really made for a very cluttered environment. So if we think about like a nursing station, you know, nurses got a lot to do and they have a very little space to do it all in. So with our monitor, the unique thing is you hang this thing on the wall, you plug in a power cable, an RJ45 network connection, you can mount it very cleanly on the wall. Then you just go back to your setup workstation. You can remotely set it up, same as you would remotely set up a camera.
Okay.
And now the monitor is displaying live video.
Okay.
No need for other boxes.
Okay. So I have on the screen at the top part is the monitor with some simple connections. At the bottom is the complex part. Just give us a quick tutorial of what that is.
Yep. All right. So traditionally, if you're going to install a system where you're taking video like from an NVR or from a workstation hiding somewhere in the back, you're going to have a KVM extender or the transmitter. Then you're going to have to run that cable out. And then you're going to have to put on the KVM receiver. Then, you know, to set that up, because you can't do it blindly, you have to plug in your keyboard and mouse to that, and then put your monitor somewhere. So you have all these essentially pieces of equipment. You have to find some place to mount, or you have to find some place to put it. These are also points of failure. Now with the IP monitor, you simply just plug in a network connection. As long as it's on the same network with your cameras, it can pull that video straight from the cameras. So it can essentially bypass all that extra equipment.
Okay. Without licensing, right?
No licensing, no software needed. So when you have to put it in a large enterprise, you know, the IT departments, they need to make sure that the Windows, they detect Windows, they have to authenticate it, make sure it's allowed on the network, they have to install their security procedures. All of that is not needed with our decoding platform, that it's simply a edge device similar to a camera.
Okay, so if your announcement that we're going to talk about here is about integration, why would somebody use it freestanding versus in an integrated format?
Yeah, so the nice thing is a lot of their larger enterprise customers where they're, you know, 30 or 40, hundreds of these monitors to give a visibility, you know, situational awareness to reception desks, to loading docks, to security offices, anywhere where you really don't have a very good line of sight. And when you have to install so many of these monitors out there, you know, you're going to have a VMS to manage your cameras. You can use the same VMS to manage our monitors as well. So you can literally click on our monitor within the VMS, click on the drag and drop the cameras that you want to display on each of our monitors. So you can see manage multiple monitors at the same time and make the setup unified within a already known environment.
So what kind of licensing is required to do that, like within Genetec or anything else that you're integrated with?
So each VMS vendor is going to have their own licensing policies, and they're going to have a license that you have to purchase from them that allows our monitor to show up as part of their tree or part of their environment. So you would have to so the user would have to contact their VMS vendor, but the market availability has been excellent. We've already, you know, we've just released it a few days ago, and we've actually already had a number of sales of the licenses.
So aside from contacting the vendor, you know, we certainly don't want end users or our integration partners to get stuck in the email strings and press one for this department, press two for that department. What's the quickest and easiest way for somebody to get some advice on either taking a look at these monitors, or if they already kind of are aware of the monitor, but they don't know how to do the integration process? What's the easiest way to maybe get a hold of you or somebody else to do that?
So the main thing is, you know, contact their sales representative. So contact the mid-chess or their local EIZO representative. They can, my information's right there on the EIZO website. They can also find me on LinkedIn, or just give a call to our office line.
Okay. And so in the notes below, in the blog post and whatnot, I'll make sure we put your contact information in there. And as always, folks in the Mid-Atlantic region are, of course, welcome to contact our team, support@midchess.com. And frankly, if you're not from our area, we'll get you in touch with Brian as well. So Brian, congratulations on the integration. I think that's going to be a big advantage for certainly people on the Genetec platform. For anybody not on Genetec, you still can use it as a freestanding system. But are there other integrations like Genetec, or is that the first, you know, full integrated solution that EIZO has worked on?
So yeah, Genetec is the first. It's our launch VMS partner. However, we already have in process a few more VMS integrations. So those will be coming out in the next 6 to 9 months. And then we have even more after that.
Okay. Well, again, I appreciate it. And in the blog post, we'll have all the details on this integration, how to contact you, and so on and so forth. So thanks a lot for joining me today.